The ADMIRAL trial is the phase 3 pivotal trial of gilteritinib, which is a selective potent type 1 FLT3 inhibitor. It's an oral agent, and it was tested in this study against parenteral chemotherapy, standard approved agents that are given to relapsed and refractory patients who have FLT3 mutation. FLT3 mutations are associated with a higher rate of relapse, particularly for FLT3 ITD mutations, and tend to be very aggressive clinically. So drugs that target FLT3, itself being a tyrosine kinase, have been long sought, and this is one of many drugs that have come down the pike to do the job of FLT3 inhibition, but really as a single agent has had some of the best results that we've seen in the clinic. This drug was very well tolerated and active in phase 1-2 testing, and now in ADMIRAL was set up head-to-head against standard chemotherapy. The study enrolled 371 patients who had relapsed disease after a prior complete remission or who were refractory to initial induction attempt. And basically, these patients were randomized 2-to-1 to either single-agent gilteritinib or the investigator's choice of one of four chemotherapy regimens, either intensive chemotherapy like MEC or FLAG-IDA, or low-intensity therapy if that was more appropriate for the patient, either azacitidine or low-dose cytarabine. From this study, we saw higher response rates in the gilteritinib arm than in the standard chemotherapy arm. We also saw higher rates of transplantation, which is the only cure for this patient population. And while not everyone was treated with the intent of going to transplant, and 20% of patients that already had a transplant when they went on the study, these were actually pretty good rates of transplantation for this population. What's gratifying is that the primary endpoint for the study, which was overall survival, was met and was superior in the gilteritinib arm at a highly statistically significant improvement in OS from 5.6 months in the control arm to 9.3 months in the gilteritinib arm. And this ultimately led to the drug's approval based on both the response and the survival data. So I'm very pleased to present this at EHA, this being the first hematology meeting where we're presenting these data.